blue-white cloning can make it much easier to select transformants that contain the insert of interest. With this technique, finding the right colonies is as easy as ignoring the blue colonies and focusing on the white ones. To perform blue-white cloning, you'll first need to make sure your competent cells are compatible with the technique. These cells are described as LacZ delta M15, meaning that they carry a mutation that deletes part of the beta-galactosidase, or LacZ gene. This results in a protein that only contains one of its necessary subunits. You'll also need a compatible plasmid, which contains a multiple cloning region within the coding sequence of the piece of LacZ that was deleted from the competent cells. This plasmid alone will restore LacZ activity, but successful ligation of your insert will disrupt the LacZ coding sequence, so the activity is not restored. Using these components, you can run your ligations and transformations as you typically would. When you're ready to plate the cells, make sure you use plates that are treated with the antibiotic you're using as a marker. For blue-white cloning, these plates should also be treated with
5-bromo-4-chloro-3-endolyl-beta-D-galactopyranosidase.
That's a mouthful. You can just call it XGAL. XGAL is the key substrate component for making the colonies turn different colors. Once the cells are plated, incubate them overnight as normal. Now, it's time to check out your colonies. Since the plates were treated with an antibiotic, the colonies most likely are made up of cells that took up your plasmid containing the resistance gene. Otherwise, they wouldn't have grown. Take a closer look and notice that some of the colonies are blue while others are white. LacZ activity in the cells will turn them blue, so you can conclude that blue colonies do not contain your insert. The white colonies do not have restored LacZ, so these contain successfully ligated DNA. These are the ones you will want to use for your future experiments. This video is brought to you by PGMT Vector Systems, now available with or without competent cells.